up, everybody? Today is it's a day in May. What day is it? How sad is it? I think it's the 27th. I want to say it's the 27th. It's the 27th. We are doing a it's the last day of school for a lot of the schools in Indiana and Kentucky. I'm actually in New Albany. I'm not going to tell you which middle school it is, but I'm at a middle school in New Albany, Indiana, and they're having a last day, like a field day. Kind of get them outside so they can enjoy the weather, so they've been cooped up inside all year with masks on because of COVID. So there's not a lot of setup to show you. There's the booth, there's the two QSC K-12s, and that's it. I'll switch it around so you can kind of see what's going on before the next class comes out here. And yeah, let's go show you exactly what we're doing here. So we got a little tent, the video booth. I'm just doing my logo on it. QSA K-12's out there. You're welcome. And that's it. Quick and dirty too. No foot skirt on the facade, or I'm sorry, on the booth. No scrims on the speakers. In and out, 10 minutes, tops. So we got the other class coming out here. This will be the only footage I take. This is gonna be at the very tip top of this gig log. And of course we got the booth going on here. Turning out to be a pretty nice day. I guess the only thing I'm really worried about are those speakers overheating. But it's not hot out. It's only like 74 degrees. It's not supposed to get much warmer than that. But if that sun really starts coming out and baking these things, I might have to move them in closer to me so I can get them undercover. But as QSCs do, they're rocking out. Loud, bassy. Can't wait to get some subs to go with it. Hey, what's up, everybody? Today is May 29th. We're at Warrenwood Manor. It's been years since I've been to this barn, but as you can tell behind me, it's a gorgeous, gorgeous barn. In fact, if you've been a longtime follower of the channel, you'll remember that this was the very first gig I ever used my Chavez Freedom Pars at. It was a crazy weekend. I had a wedding here in Danville, Kentucky, which is about an hour and a half south of Louisville. And then I had a wedding Saturday of that week up in Muncie, Indiana. And then I had a Sunday wedding in Louisville. So it was this crazy geography that tons and tons of driving. Today is not the case. I do have a wedding tomorrow, but it's at Ashford Acres. So not as crazy of a weekend. It's Memorial Day weekend and it's 50 degrees outside. It is so cold. Complete opposite of last week. Last week it was freaking hot. It was in the 90s. But I mean, I don't sweat as much, but when I'm cold, my hands get really, really cold, and it's just, it's harder for me to perform when my hands are freezing. But we're gonna turn you around, we're gonna show you the setup. I finally got the new uplighting patched into my DMX 2.0. So we are now operating everything wirelessly from the booth, which is awesome. I only brought 16 units to this particular barn because it's all we needed. There were, 14 to go down the pillars and each door, and then two kind of highlighting the sides of the booth. Let's go check that out. So nothing too fancy with the booth. I brought totems, but I couldn't set them up. Because if you go over here, you'll notice this speaker is leaning because the floor is really uneven. And I just didn't want a chance bringing the totems in and one of them tipping over or something like that. Plus, when you set up totems, they would be right, the lighting fixtures would be right with these beams and they wouldn't shine out. So we're just gonna light the barn, dance-wise, flood it with all the uplighting. So I've made a bunch of profiles. We got static blush. I made that one because their color is blush today. But we got static amber, white, blue, green, red, white strobe, rainbow strobe, pulse change, color fade, and blackout. We're in blackout now, but if we go to color fade, they all turn on. Do a little color fade, color change. It's kind of like your dance active mode, your sound active mode with the Freedom Pars. Pulse change, this one's pretty fun. So they literally just pulse. It'll look like it's pulsing to the music. There's a rainbow strobe function where they strobe in all different kinds of colors. Then there's a white strobe that'll be used a lot for grand entrances. Then static red, green, blue, white, amber and static blush for today. But we're gonna go ahead and black them out to save the batteries. Now let's go look at the ceremony system. So we actually have some wet weather cover. We're under a carport. So we're actually really well hidden from the ceremony. We have the battery powered system today. In fact, I'm actually working with a wedding planner today that I worked with in Campbellsville a couple of years ago. That particular ceremony was about 300 yards into a field, and I had to go and buy tons of extension cord. I just didn't have enough. It actually is what inspired this setup, this all battery powered setup. And as you can see, there's already guests arriving. So I'm gonna go ahead and get dressed, get my hair done, and get ready for the show. Stay tuned, a lot more to come.
Like rain on an old tin roof, and your hand fits right.